accessing and finding your way around the family ledger. When you come into the Family Data and Accounting module, you can access a family's ledger by clicking the ledger icon in the account icon row. Another access method is to go to the account menu and choose the ledger option here, or just press the F8 key on your keyboard. And lastly, you can highlight the balance on a particular account and then with your mouse on the balance, double click. That will take you directly into the ledger card. When you're in the ledger card, we have arrows at the top to move to the previous account or move down to the next account. So you can move up or down among accounts here. You can also display various ledgers. If the account only has a primary or private ledger only, you'll only see one ledger showing there. I'll move to an account that has both a private ledger and a Department of Human Resources ledger. This is the kind of thing you would see if they have a subsidy for the family. So you'll access various ledgers that way. You also have an option to hide voids and group options here. Let's move back to the Adams account. We've got some voided lines that show as pink lines right here. Any payment or credit lines are going to show as yellow, and all of the charge lines are going to show as blue lines. So a voided line is pink, and they are not included on customer statements. You can hide them from view as well by clicking the Hide Voids button. That will remove them from all ledgers as you move among families. Any voids would be hidden until you re-click that item to show voids, then they'll be revealed. You also can group all of your transactions on the ledger cards by the description. For example, the charge description, the discount description, or the payment description. This is handy when you're looking for something like a payment on a particular account and you'd like to see all of the payments together and just kind of look back through the history and see if you can find the check that way. Quite simply, just ungroup and everything is displayed then in chronological order. Going across the bottom, the void button allows you to void a transaction that is not locked. Something like this, a payment with a lock on it, means that that payment has been deposited into the bank. And if I double click the lock, you can see what deposit report that particular payment was on. Any line that's eligible to be voided will allow the void button to light up. If it's a locked payment like that, you'll see the void button is grayed out. So you would pick the item, click void, and then just supply the void date here, and then void. The sort button places items in date order as you are entering them in the ledger, but it is seldom used since once an item is posted, it's automatically sorted by date. The audit button will show you any changes made to items on the ledger that have a history, and there was a change made to that particular item. The deposits button is for tracking special charges and special credits. These are usually amounts that are paid in advance for tuition later on, such as a summer program or fall registration. The report button allows you to generate a specific report for just this family, such as the standard customer statement and so forth. And then Tuition Express Point of Sale. This button is used to process a Tuition Express point of sale credit card payment by swiping it through a card swipe reader. That would populate this information right here, and then you can supply the amount of the payment there and process it. That would post the payment in that ledger card. That's how to access and get around the family ledger card.